today I want to talk about being anchored in God. Okay, being anchored in God or being stable in God. Just want to bring a word of encouragement to lift our spirits and to just tell us to hold on to God. You know, to not let anything sway us away from the promise that we have in God. The psalmist writes in Psalm 112 and verse 7, he says that a person who believes in God, his heart is steadfast, trusting in the Lord. So we function out of our place of trust. We function out of our place of dependence on God. So our heart is steadfast. No matter what we go through, our heart is steadfast, trusting in the Lord. So today I want to share three keys which will help us as believers remain steady in God. So the first key that I will be talking about is the key of intimacy. So for us as believers to remain steady in God, the first thing we need is to be anchored in intimacy. The second anchor that we must have in our lives is that of being anchored in purpose, or God's purpose. And the third one is to be anchored in the truth of God's word. So the first one here is remaining anchored in intimacy. Remaining anchored in intimacy. And I'm reminded of the life of Jesus. Okay, wasn't easy at all for the Son of God. You know, just think about his beginning. He was born in a manger. And then, yes, as he lived through his life, we would think that the Son of God will have it all easy. But, you know, that wasn't the case. So he worked as a carpenter, was faithful to his family. And then, you know, at some point when it was time for him to step out in the ministry, he did. But, you know, then there was a lot of opposition. There were so many challenges that he faced. And towards, you know, the end of his lifetime, when he did what God called him to do, which is to be crucified on the cross, you know, he faced just about every human challenge that you and I could face. You know, rejection, accusation, you know, so many different things that he actually had to face as the Son of God. But his walk was one of stability. The anchor which he had as the Son of God was his relationship with the Father. Now, he was intimate with the Father. Now, he related closely with the Father. Today, I want to remind us, church, that our strength lies in our intimacy with God. Our strength lies in our intimacy with the Father. The second anchor here is purpose. Okay, to be anchored in purpose. Now, even as we look at the life of Jesus, you know, Jesus is always our best example. In Hebrews 12:2, we see Jesus says that, you know, he is ready to walk into the purposes of God, even the difficult purpose, which is to die on the cross, because he was looking at the joy ahead of him, what that purpose would accomplish for the kingdom of God. So he was looking ahead. And when we are looking ahead, we are able to go through some stuff, and those things don't crush us. So it is important for us to be anchored in purpose. And the third anchor that I want to talk about is to remain anchored in the truth of God's word. John 17:17, Jesus said, "Sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth." And Jesus, describing himself, he said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." So Jesus is the truth. He is the word. And that word is the truth. And we need to remain anchored in the truth. We need to remain anchored in the word of God. And as long as we are anchored in the word of God, the truth of God's word, the enemy cannot play mind games with us, because we are renewed in our minds with the truth of God's word. I'll just share three aspects where we must be careful to know, to believe, and to declare the truth. The first one is to know the truth about God and know the truth about the gospel. Remain anchored to the truth of our identity in Christ. Scripture also tells us that God has provided wisdom for everything pertaining to life. And it comes from scriptures. And as long as we are anchored in this way, we're anchored in intimacy with God, we're anchored in the purpose that God has for us, and anchored in the truth of God's word, we will remain stable.